Hi everyone, it's Christian here from the eCreators Academy. Today I'm wanting to talk to you about custom profile fields. Now these are fields and additional pieces of information that we can add to the user's profile and collect about them. Now for some people, custom profile fields might simply be just for data recording purposes, so that we want to collect some information, maybe about a date of birth of each of our users, maybe what state they've come from. But in other cases where people want to take it a bit further, a custom profile field might be used to give access to people to certain courses. So in this example that I was going to talk about, perhaps I want to record whether people have come from New South Wales, Victoria, South Australia, and so on. And based off that, they are going to get enrolled into certain courses. So I actually need, and there's a couple of pieces to that, but the main thing that I need then is to create a custom profile field for state that will then allow me to use the information that's held within that later down the track. So let's just have a look a little bit at what we've got here. So as an admin, I've logged in and I'm under the My Users tab on the left-hand side, and I went into Create New User. So this is the screen that I'm looking at here. So when you have a look here through this screen, we've got all the typical Moodle fields, all those common fields, profile pictures, usernames, passwords, first name, last name. But in my case, and in the sample that I was showing you, or just talking about, is that I want to be able to record their state. So additional names, nothing about state. Interests, that's talking about tags, so still nothing about state. Optional, okay, we're getting a bit closer here, but still nothing about state. So this is where we sort of say to ourselves, okay, well, we're going to need our own profile field. So you can see here we've got other fields and there's the profile background image, but still nothing about state. Okay, so we need to build our own. So to do this, I'm going to go down to the Administration tab, and again, I'll go back into Site Administration. We go across to the second tab along, the Users tab. Under Accounts, we go to User Profile Fields, about halfway down that list, and we'll click on that. Now there's two sections to our profile fields. We can create our own profile categories, which is sort of like the folder structure. So as you can see here, Other Fields is a profile category. And then within each of those categories, we can then add fields themselves. So we can have one or many categories, it's totally up to you. And these categories will show in that collapsible form when you go to create a new user. Now, if you do create a profile category and you don't have any fields within it, it won't show up. So it'll remain invisible when you're trying to create a user. So just keep that in mind. If you've gone and created a category but didn't put anything in it, it won't actually display. So you haven't done anything wrong, it's just that you always need a field, at least one, within a category for it to show up. So I'm not going to use the other fields one. I'm going to create a category called eCreators, for example. So I clicked on the Create New Category, and I'm just going to call it eCreators. And I'm going to click Save Changes. Now you could call it whatever you like. You could call it your state, if you want, if there was only going to be just that one field in there. So currently showing here, I have two categories now. One called Other Fields, which has the profile background image in it. And then the eCreators category, which is now I can choose from as to what fields I want to put in there. So if you look at the bottom of this page here, we create a new profile field and we can choose any one of these types. So is it just simply a checkbox? Is it a time and date range? So maybe is it the date the employee started? Maybe their birth date? Maybe the day they completed their induction, whatever it might be. A drop-down menu, which is very typically used, especially if we're integrating this with giving them permissions to something else. Because the thing with the drop-down menu is that it keeps data accurate. So, you know, if, for example, I had someone that was from New South Wales, one person might write it NSW, the other person might write New South Wales. And I'm going to have to capture all these different versions. So by having a drop-down menu, it means that I can keep it exact. A file upload area, a text area, or a text input. So this is basically just the difference between a text box and just one line of text. So that's the difference there. So in my case, because I want accuracy, I'm going to say drop-down menu. Now, the short name. So this is what the database uses. So in my case, I'm just going to call it the state field. The name is what the user sees. So the short name is what the database uses and what we use when we do bulk uploading in the CSV file. And the name is what the user sees. So that's where it's grammatically correct, capital letters, all those sort of things. a description of the field if you want. You're welcome to add it there. And then just a couple of other options. So is the field required? Is the field locked? Therefore, does that mean that the user can actually access that data and edit it? Or is it just only the uploads that can do that? Should the data be unique? So can anybody else have the same answer? Should we display it on the sign-up page, which links with the actual self-email-based registration? Who is the field visible to? And what category is that field actually going in? So you can select all of that there. Just one little thing I do want to talk about here is this field required? Just remember and be careful with this one. If you say yes to that and actually toggle that to yes, if there is existing users already in the system, the first login after this has been set to yes is going to take them straight to their profile page, and every user will have to answer this question, because basically the database is now looking at all these records saying, I have a required field, and for all these users it's empty. So before we can continue, they must complete it. Now that can be a little bit confusing for users sometimes, because they're going and logging into the system, and suddenly now they're being taken straight to their user profile page, and they're not quite sure what to do. So if you are going to introduce a new required field, just make sure that you communicate that out to all your users so they know exactly what's going on and what's going to be expected of them. All right, so as we move down the page a bit further, we can then go to our options, so the specific settings around this. So as it says, they're one per line. So these are all the options that are going to appear in that dropdown. So here are all my states. And if I want, I can provide a default value. So this is one that it will always be selected, and the user can then change it from that if they're going to be using another one. So mostly your default value would be the most common item that's going to be selected. And we click Save Changes. So as you can see, we've now set up our new category, and we've also set up our new profile field called State. So if I was to go across and create a new user, so under My Users on the left-hand side and click Create New User, you'll now see how this looks. So the changes take effect straight away. So here's the other field drop-down, and then here's the eCreators one that we've just created. There's the state, which is selected as Victoria by default, drop-down, and we can now select from all the others within that list. And you're done. So thanks for watching. I hope that's helped and given you a bit more information about custom profile fields. Just remember, there is a lot of things that we can do to automate these as well. So this is where we talk about using the advanced cohorts option, in which we can enroll people into courses based off answers to certain custom profile fields within their profile. So there's a lot of different options, and there's lots more help articles and videos from us around this as well. So I hope that's helped, and we'll talk to you soon.